Just a quick video here for those of you that have the same issue as me where the screen on your phone stops working in terms of touch interface. As you can see here, I can't do anything on the phone. It doesn't work. And I have files and documents on here that I need to recover. Without being able to control their interface, it's kind of hard to recover the files.
Fracking Creations, a YouTube variety channel that touches different parts of your life.
Want more videos on tech?
Subscribe to the channel or check out our website.
You want to be able to control the interface, so what you can do is use a USB keyboard and a USB mouse. Now, in order to use both of these, I've connected them to a USB hub with the dongle for the mouse and the connection for the keyboard. And all this runs through the port to the cable that you normally connect to your computer or laptop or desktop would be then connected to your phone. Normally, you connect to your laptop using USB-A, so we have an adapter here that converts that to micro USB, then to USB-C. So I plug that in, and with that being done, you're able to easily control the interface and log in and type on the phone. So you see there, that's the mouse right there. Okay, so the reason why you need this is you need to be able to log into the phone. You may say, well, you can use your fingerprint scanner if you have that programmed in, but in terms of these Android phones, if you've rebooted it, or your power ran out and you need to restart it, the first thing it needs is your password to be entered, so you won't be using fingerprint. Now, that's not the end of it. I have my computer here, and we have the USB-C cable that you can connect to your phone. Now, the way this phone is set up is once I connect it, I still need to enable the connection for the laptop to be able to access the files on this device. When I unplug this hub from the phone, I can no longer use this keyboard and mouse to control the interface. So what you want to do when you have this plugged in initially is to use a Bluetooth mouse like this or any other Bluetooth mice, and basically go and use this USB mouse to enable Bluetooth on this device and then sync up with your Bluetooth mouse. Now, if you have a Bluetooth keyboard like this Logitech one here, you can also connect it too so that you can type on here once you disconnect the hub. Once those are connected, you can then plug in your micro USB cord so that it's connected to your laptop. Once I connect it, my laptop cannot access the phone yet. So I need to go and enable the connection to the laptop. So as you can see, I'm able to use the Bluetooth mouse, and then on this system, I need to click on the Android system connection for USB. Once I do that, I can then say I want to allow use USB for file transfer. So I click on that. And you can see here that the drive is here. From there, I can then download all the files that I need, look through all the folders, and back up my phone, especially pictures too, or any other folders that I have set up. If you need links to where to buy these adapters, just check our video description, and you can get some for yourself. Thanks for watching the video. I hope this helps other people that have the same issue to resolve their problems.